Chapter 3 of Fortnite, a new era and along with it a new chapter of competitive play. 2022 is set to be one of the best years of competitive Fortnite in a while. Not only is FNCS going to be duos, making it much easier to find a good teammate to play with, but tournaments are going to be shorter, have larger prize pools, and have two rounds, making it much easier for players to earn themselves some money. In this video, I'm going to teach you everything you need to know to go pro in Fortnite. Now, whether you're planning on going pro or just trying to earn some extra cash for yourself, what you practice is going to have the biggest effect on how you play in tournaments. How you train your aim, how you practice your mechanics, and even how you play arena is going to affect your skill as a player. Now, with that being said, I highly suggest you go ahead and invest in your aim and buy Kovacs. By practicing in Kovacs, you'll greatly improve your mouse control, which will overall make your aim smoother and more accurate over time. Now, when you are playing Fortnite, you should always be working on improving your skills and never be playing the game just to play. There should never be a time when you're playing Fortnite and not getting better. You should focus on improving every single one of your skills so that you're never getting behind the competitive curve. The best way to do this is by evaluating what you're good at and what you're not. This will allow you to set up your own personal routine that will hammer down on those skills that you need to improve the most. An example of this for myself is that I should play more scrims than arena or creative because I'm already a very good fighter, but I only have a little bit of endgame knowledge. By playing more scrims, it would give me the most beneficial practice for me as a player. Now, evaluating yourself leads right into my next topic, and that is your mentality. A lot of Fortnite players have massive egos, and this leads to their downfall. Knowing that there's always going to be someone better than you out there might be the biggest motivation I can give you. The fact that you are not the best player in the world means that you have room to get better. After all, no one is perfect and everyone makes mistakes. How you handle those mistakes and build off your losses separates you from the rest of the group. Every death you have is a lesson to be learned, so stop complaining because your death is always your fault. After knowing this, it will make it much easier to stay positive when playing, which will overall make you a much more consistent player. How you look at the game will affect how you play, so always remember that there will be another chance. But till then, focus on every match as if this one game is for $1 million. This will help you win more games and place higher on the leaderboard. Another skill that will help you place higher on the leaderboard is one that I never hear people talk about, and this is playing and abusing the meta. Whether you're running an SMG only, using shadow floppers until top 5, or just sitting in a bush to get a free kill, playing the meta is the most underrated skill of being a pro player. This is because if you win a cash cup by doing this, someone is going to call you cringe, but remember, this is always going to be someone to do this, so why not let it be you? If the only reason you do not place in a tournament is because you chose not to play the meta when your opponents did, you are going to regret it. At one point, every pro has abused the meta, so go ahead and give yourself an unfair advantage. Along with playing the meta, you need to become a dynamic player. This means that you are going to be able to change and adapt to what works best. This will allow you to stay ahead of the competitive curve so that you can dominate the top of the leaderboards. Being able to adapt to changing metas will allow you to have a competitive advantage over all of your opponents. Staying one step in front of everyone else might just be what it takes for you to become a pro player. The best way to do this is by trying new things when you're practicing and playing scrims so that you know what works and what doesn't. Along with this, you need to make sure that you VOD review the players that are winning tournaments so that you know exactly what it takes to win. I recommend that you set aside one day of the week just to do this so that you can write down everything important that you see. Doing this, it will help you improve so much faster as you will know the best strategies and how to do them correctly. Most players do not VOD review at all, and this is one of the biggest things holding them back from becoming a pro player. Okay, so obviously buying better gear and upgrading your setup is going to make it much easier for you to get better at the game, but if you have no way of getting the money to do so, you should still play to the best of your abilities. A lot of players have placed highly or even made money while on bad setups, so why can't you do it? When you die, accept the responsibility for that death and try not to blame it on something you can't control like ping or FPS. This will make it much easier for you to get better as a player because you will realize your mistakes much faster and learn from them as well. This is one of the most underrated skills of being a pro player, and that is accepting responsibility. Especially now in duos where you and your duo has to put full faith in each other at any given moment, if one of you make a mistake, it can cost you the entire game, so it's crucial that you accept when you are wrong and you make a wrong mistake. Now, when you do make a mistake, it's also extremely important that you actually learn from it. Once you're able to do this, you'll find yourself improving so much faster with your duo, and you'll start placing higher as well. Being able to openly communicate with your teammates and accept criticism will help you out when in the long run when it comes to getting better as a team, and also will help you improve your solo gameplay as well. But now, when you are trying to find a duo, make sure that you pick someone that you actually enjoy playing with. This will make it much easier for you to stay positive during tournaments, and that will make you a more consistent player. Along with this, make sure that when you do choose a duo partner, that you stick with them the entire year. After every tournament you play with them, make sure to VOD review your games and see where you can get better. Then play scrims, implementing those improvements, and after just a couple days, you will see you and your duo getting much better and playing off together, which will overall make you a much better team. A lot of people do bad in one tournament and then immediately split with their teammate, and this is the worst thing that you can do, because not only do you not learn anything from that tournament, but you also lose all of that practice you had with that player. It is almost as if you completely reset everything that you have done and been working for. With that being said, it is extremely important that when you do choose your duo, that they are positive, want to grind, and are around the same skill level as you. This will make it much easier for you to get better with them and overall place higher in tournaments. Now, a bunch of you guys are going to be looking at solos to get your first earnings, and this is probably because you do not have to rely on anyone else. Solos is always a great way to make money playing Fortnite, and will give you more recognition over playing team mode, since you are the only person responsible for your placement. Overall, placing in solos will help you find better players to play with and better teammates to play tournaments. But solos can be very tilting and difficult if you do not know how to play consistently. In solos, if you want to place top 10 of a tournament, you need to be consistently getting top 5 every single match you play. Kills are not nearly as important in solos, because every kill should be a refresh rather than just trying to get those kill points. Currently, the competitive format rewards players that get top 10 of a match much more than someone who W keys the entire game. With that being said, you should be learning how to rotate so that you can get to the end game every single match. Along with this, make sure that you set up your early and mid game so when you do get into the end game, you will have the best loadout possible, along with some movement as well. This will make it much easier for you to play consistently and overall place higher in the tournament. One of the most underrated skills of solos is learning how to disengage from a fight. Most players believe that if you do get in a fight, you have to take that fight until someone dies, but this is extremely risky because you never know if you're going to win the fight, and you can't win every single fight, so one day you are going to lose one. But if you learn how to disengage from a fight, you will ensure that you survive and make it to endgame where all the placement points are. If you do learn how to do this, it will help you out when it comes to making every single game count, and you will become a much more consistent player. Chapter 3 of Fortnite is a great opportunity for you to go pro and make money playing tournaments. Every single one of you guys have what it takes, you just have to put in the work until it pays off. I will have much more in-depth guides coming soon, as I upload every week, so don't forget to subscribe. I hope this video was helpful, and I hope you guys have an amazing holiday season. Peace out, guys.